You were introduced to man-made radiation when you had your first chest x-ray. There is another source of radiation that has been harnessed by man and is important to all of us. Nuclear energy. Nuclear energy serves as a vital resource in agriculture, medicine, industry, environmental protection, research, and generation of electricity. In agriculture, nuclear technology is improving crop varieties such as rice and ornamental plants. In medicine, radioactive substances such as radiopharmaceuticals are indispensable in the diagnosis and treatment of various diseases. In industry, radiation is being used to improve the qualities of industrial raw materials, products, and processes. Safe, peaceful, productive. This is Nuclear Technology Today. The Philippines entered the nuclear age in 1958 with the creation of the Philippine Atomic Energy Commission. In 1987, it was renamed the Philippine Nuclear Research Institute, or PNRI. It is one of the research and development institutes of the Department of Science and Technology. As the center of all nuclear science and technology activities in the country, the PNRI is mandated to conduct research and development on the applications of radiation and nuclear techniques, materials, and processes. Undertake the transfer of research results to end users. Operate and maintain nuclear research reactors and other radiation facilities. And license and regulate the possession and application of all nuclear and radioactive substances. To meet its objectives, PNRI implements these programs: nuclear research and development, nuclear services, nuclear safety and regulations, and technology diffusion. The Institute's programs in nuclear research and development focus on applications of radiation in agriculture, health, industry, and the environment. Crop improvement studies using radiation sources have produced high-yielding mutant varieties of rice, ornamental plants, and other food crops. Radiation technology has been used to improve the characteristics of adlai, which may serve as a substitute for rice and corn. Scientists use isotope tracer techniques to determine the right amount and proper timing of fertilizer application on food crops. The Institute has developed plant growth promoter, or PGP, from radiation-modified carrageenan for use as plant food supplement. The PGP can increase yield of rice by more than 20% and make the plants more resistant to blight and infestations. Radiation is used to control the population of various pests that damage agricultural crops. The sterile insect technique, or SIT, has been used against fruit flies that infest export fruits like mangoes. The PNRI also applies SIT to help mitigate the perennial dengue problem in the Philippines. Researchers developed a radiation-based quarantine treatment against the mango pulp weevil, which finally allows more Philippine mango exports to enter into the United States. PNRI studies have shown that food irradiation can prolong the shelf life of agricultural products, disinfest grains and export fruits, and reduce or destroy microorganisms in food commodities. In medicine, the Institute established a facility for the local production of technetium-99m, the most commonly used medical radioisotope in the country. The PNRI has developed hydrogels from carrageenan and polyvinyl pyrrolidone. These hydrogels can be used as dressing for burns, wounds, and bed sores. Another type of dressing for wounds was developed by researchers from local honey sources. Researchers formulated hemostats to reduce or stop the bleeding in wounds or skin openings from military or civilian trauma. Nuclear techniques such as receptor binding assay are also useful in the management of red tide or harmful algal blooms. Radiation techniques are being used in industries to find defects of internal components and structures without interrupting normal plant operations. The Institute develops nuclear techniques for characterizing materials which are important to the academic and industrial sectors. As part of PNRI's radiation protection activities, researchers monitor natural and man-made radioactivity in the environment and establishes real-time environmental monitoring systems in the Philippines. As the national focal point for the Comprehensive Nuclear Test Ban Treaty Organization, the Institute operates a radionuclide monitoring station in Tanay, Rizal. The PNRI applies nuclear analytical techniques as tools to identify major sources of air pollution and to estimate the contribution of these sources for better air quality management. Isotope and chemical techniques are used to analyze freshwater systems for better management of water resources. To widen the application of nuclear technology, the Institute extends nuclear and allied services to various sectors. The multipurpose irradiation facility, electron beam irradiation facility, and the gamma cell 220 are the facilities used in providing irradiation services. The multipurpose irradiation facility operates on a semi-commercial scale for microbial decontamination, shelf life extension, sterilization, and for research applications. The electron beam irradiation facility is intended for research and development and for semi-commercial services. The gamma cell 220 is used for small volumes of samples requiring low radiation doses. Radiation protection services are extended to licensed users of ionizing radiation. This is to ensure that exposure of workers to radiation are monitored and controlled. The Institute operates and maintains a Secondary Standards Dosimetry Laboratory, or SSDL, to ensure accurate and traceable radiation measurements. The PNRI operates the only centralized radioactive waste management facility for low and intermediate level radioactive wastes in the country. This provides for the treatment and temporary storage of these used radioactive sources and other waste packages for future transfer to a final repository site. For multi-element analysis of various products and for certification of compliance of food experts to non-radioactivity standards, clients may avail of PNRI's nuclear-based analytical services. Radiation monitoring and detection instruments. These can be fabricated and repaired by highly skilled PNRI technicians. Human chromosomes can be analyzed at the Institute's Cytogenetics Laboratory to assess possible exposure of radiation workers and to detect abnormalities or genetic disorders. Nuclear safety and regulations is another major program of PNRI. To ensure safety and security of nuclear and radioactive materials, the Institute develops regulations, administrative orders, guides, and bulletins for licensed facilities and activities. Licenses for radioactive material and facilities are issued for the authority to use, own, and transfer of radioactive materials. The PNRI conducts inspection and audit of licensed radioactive material users and facilities to verify and monitor licensees' compliance with the law, regulations, and the conditions of the license issued. The Institute also coordinates with various government agencies to prevent diversion, theft, and sabotage involving nuclear and other radioactive materials. PNRI continues to build the capability of the country to respond in the event of a radiation-related emergency through the National Radiological Emergency Preparedness and Response Plan. Thousands of Filipinos have become aware of the beneficial uses of nuclear science and technology through the Institute's information, education, and technology transfer activities. These include nuclear awareness seminars, guided tours of PNRI facilities, SNT fairs and exhibitions, media publicity, and library services. The Institute participates in an educational outreach program in the Asia-Pacific region to bring nuclear science to high school classrooms. The Nuclear Training Center conducts training courses on nuclear science and technology, radiation safety, and non-destructive testing for various sectors. The Institute also offers theses and research advisorship and on-the-job training for students and researchers. For the commercialization of research outputs, the Institute conducts technology transfer activities and provides innovation management services for intellectual property protection. Local linkages and collaborations are made by PNRI with other government agencies and scientific institutions, the academe, and the private sectors to enhance the Institute's nuclear capability. On an international level, the PNRI serves as the link between the International Atomic Energy Agency, or IAEA, and government and private entities using nuclear technology. The Institute also has cooperative agreements on nuclear technology with other international organizations. By committing itself to the advancement of nuclear science and technology, the PNRI has forged the peaceful applications of nuclear technology into an exciting and potent tool for national development. Its priority projects have shown that nuclear technology has always been our ally, quietly advancing agriculture, medicine, and industry, and that a better public understanding of its nature and potentials for development can put this nation on the fast lane towards industrialization. With its untiring efforts and exacting leadership, the Philippine Nuclear Research Institute has proven that nuclear technology can work for each Filipino, giving him a better quality of life now and the years to come.